and how the act of sex is a pious and a pure thing, and how the organs given by nature should be kept pure, how the health aspect of the individual should be kept pure, so that a pure child can be produced in the next generation. These are the little dimensions that you should project through the to the child between the years of 7 and 14, so that after the age of 14, before 21, the child should be able to make a proper use of his sex faculties and should be able to withstand the glamour and temptation to go into the indulgence levels, so that he may appreciate how nature introduces monogamy through plants, how one flower when fertilized cannot be touched by another male part of another flower, and how the animals and the plants show the proper timings and improper timings of sex application. How to the human being also there are proper timings and improper timings for sex. This may appear a bit queer and odd to some of you, but there is no compromise in trying to understand facts and stating them, so that the physical mechanism of the child may not be a cripple even at an early age through misuse or disuse. Unless you make a scientific teaching of proper use of any instrument, you cannot control a child from misuse and disuse of the machine. And also, any machine, when misused, can be replaced by purchasing a new machine. But when the human machine is crippled, there is no doctor who can replace a part of this machine. And when one is deficient at an early age, the parts of his body can never be replaced by any doctor. And this aspect should be projected upon the mind of the child before the child develops into 14th year. And then hygiene and cleanliness should be properly taught. The student should be made self-supporting and self-sufficient in matters of health. That is, a routine is to be prescribed to the child, which the child follows by imitating the teachers. Unless the parent or the teacher is also involved, this method of teaching is not possible. A teacher or a parent who prescribes to the child a routine and timing, at the same time, if he does not follow, the child loses confidence upon the child or the parent very easily. Because children grow by having confidence upon people elder than themselves. No vacuum should be created in their confidence about the elders. It is here we, the modern elders, miserably failed with the children. However wonderful our teaching methods may be to the children, when the child has no confidence in us, has no hope of the future in the elders, the child has no interest or incentive to follow what you prescribe. In other words, unless the elder is involved in what he teaches, the child is never involved in what he learns. And this fact has no exception anywhere. So this is one dimension. Prescribe a daily routine. and you, the teacher or parent, begin to follow it happily. Do not impose it on the child. Let the child take interest in imitating you. Then encourage the child when it begins to imitate you. This is how you have to start. And another aspect, from the age of 14, you have to take care is, regulate the thinking of the child. How? Is it by applying most psychological methods of teaching? Not possible. Is it by teaching the most valuable things in the world to the child? Not possible. Regulating thinking is possible only if the child applies to physical work. Unless the body is applied to some work, thought can never be regulated. One can develop into a great philosopher or a great intellect or an educationalist or a great politician or a great theologian, but unless there is the physical aspect of application of work, the fellow has no regulating of his thoughts. And such an intellectual fellow, with all his intellect, deceives the society and nothing else. If he is a politician, he will deceive the world in the political field. And whatever way he applies his life, he can just take the best advantage from the society without being useful to the society. That means he can commercialize his activity and make the worst use of the society with what he knows. So, regulating the thinking of the child by applying the child to physical work and labor is most important. I told you it may be the housemaking science, beginning with brick making or carpentry, etc. Let the child be developed to make one house independently, or one cottage independently, or let two or three children make one house, or food making methods, technical methods. Let the child work in the garden and produce fruits. Or let the child apply herself or himself to agriculture. Or cattle tending and milk farm. Or something belonging to clothing. Let the advanced technology in the cities continue and progress. The child should be trained into these lines, not because the society needs it, not because that there is less of production in the country, but because the child needs such a training. This should be an inevitable education to the child. There should be regular hours to work in one of these applied fields. And at the same time, have the B aspect of the same education. That is, you supply the child with the most up-to-date literature of the concerned work it is doing. If the child is doing garden work, let the garden science books be supplied to the child. If it is doing the work of the fruits in the garden, let the books, up-to-date books in producing fruits be supplied. Like that, you should arrange the library in a clever manner, so that the child is tempted to seek its own literature in the library. Now the two dimensions develop automatically. That is the synthetic and the analytical faculties. They develop automatically. And at this stage, you can use the most modern implements of the technological discoveries. You can provide education through video to the child. We should never mean curbing the modern metropolitan methods of teaching. We need not go back in time into the ancient days. Time is always in the form of cycles. It has only one-way traffic. Even though some people want to go back into the ancient days, it is not possible. Their vehicles are not allowed in the other direction because the traffic is only one way. Time progresses in one direction, and you can utilize what all is there in the modern world for the sake of the child. But at the same time, remember that time makes people travel only in spirals, not straight line. Remember, progress is never unilateral or unidimensional. It is not linear. It is multidimensional, like the growth of a balloon, a cube from center, a globe from center to circumference. That is how nature provides us. That is how nature helps us to develop. You can see how the solar systems develop in nature, always in the form of globes. See how the planets develop in nature, always in the form of globes. See how the planets go around the sun, always in cycles. There is no linear movement in nature at all. It is only our intellectual self-deception which we think linear. So in our progress also, we should know the message of nature and apply it accordingly. So let us also progress in giving the education to the children. Let us not go back, because children belong to our next generation, not the previous generation. So if we are to be successful in giving education to the children, we should be prepared to travel forwards, not backwards. The only care we have to take is not to take negative steps in our hasty way of doing. That is, not to allow the child to develop into negative values. You should help the child only to understand others, not to misunderstand others, and to know and appreciate the law of inclusion without exclusion. That is what is badly needed in these days, because unfortunately we are trained very much into exclusion than inclusion. I can understand you as a citizen of Belgium, remembering myself as a citizen of India, but I should be trained to understand you as a human being having the same needs and same mentality and same logic. The understanding of Belgian or Russian or American or German or Indian may be there for convenience. The right type of progress into internationalism should be the first step of our education of the child. So provide the child with the literature and the up-to-date methods of video and television. And in the next step, that is from 14 years of age, the child may be allowed to earn for itself, because it knows many crafts by this time. When it knows how to build a house, when it knows how to make a garden, when it knows how to make an agricultural farm or a dairy farm, the child can very easily begin to earn. And then let it continue the education. The method of stopping education and continuing earning need no more be conceived, because whether we accept it or not, we are continuing to learn things as long as we are living. And in some sense or other, many of us are students until we die. There may be an exception to it, but it is very, very, very low percentage. There are not even 1% of people who stop to be students in their life. We may not be knowing it, but we are students still. So let the child develop into the next steps of education. This should be know thyself education. Let the child know what health is, what ill health is, and how to maintain health, the science of health. I told you yesterday, I warned you that the present medical science is not at all the science of health required. With due respect to all the great achievements that are being made by the modern medical education, unfortunately, the approach is essentially negative. We are teaching a science of disease, not the science of health. The same information may be used, but from a different point of view. The child should know how to live healthily, not how to cure itself. So the science of health should be once again framed into textbooks of the new era. In doing so, we need not be ashamed of borrowing from ancient books. We should be ready to go into the future, but we should be ready to go into the past also. Let us have no limitations and conceits and complexes about the future or the past. If you go into the national scriptures of various nations in the past ages, and if you go into the works of great people, great thinkers of the ancient days, like Hippocrates, Paracels, and the ancient sages of the Ayurvedic science, and if you go into the ancient Egyptian, Greek, and Indian, and Chaldean literatures, you can make ideal books in the science of health. And if you can add the modern science of dietetics and other things also with this, add naturopathy and homeopathy also with this, you can give to the student what he has to do to keep himself healthy. He should have the science of health, and he should have a science of the sacred science called astrology. We should not be ashamed of accepting that astrology is a science, because to criticize such an branches of knowledge is orthodoxy which should be condemned. All branches of knowledge should be taken into consideration. And sciences like astrology and palmistry and phrenology should be taken into account. Then he will have a faint understanding of what we call the science of man. This is badly needed. There is no university now which has the stature to teach this science. And then the student should be able to know about his own psychology, so that he may not need a psychological advisor. And he should know his own temperament. and he should be able to select his own proper mate in life, and she should be able to select her own proper mate in life. Some people may laugh at the idea, but do you know that the world was like that some centuries ago? Do you know that the world enjoyed life at most in the light of these sciences? So that selecting a companion in life may not be a trial and error method, so that it may not be a blind chance. What's the good of our trying to find our mate again and again, and rejecting and divorcing and selecting a new one and divorcing and selecting a new one, like an emotional fool, and then finding the correct companion at the age of 50 or 60, and when there are nations who could follow the procedure? The nations had no necessity to have a trial and error method, and then they had their own concepts of purity of vehicles when monogamy was a pleasure in those days. There are still some nations which are in a primitive state. For example, India and some areas of Africa, where monogamy is the rule for 85% of the couples. And this science should be once again revived before it fades away from the eyes of humanity. And the capacity to select proper timings for the couples to mate or not should be understood by themselves. Then sex becomes an enjoyment and not an excitement. Unfortunately, in the modern times, for many people, sex is an only excitement and not enjoyment. Such a student will know what happiness is and what pleasure is in life. And he knows the time when he and she know the time when they can produce an ideal child. And this should be a part of the education that is to be imparted to the child. And after the age of 21 and before 28, it is prescribed in the scriptures of various nations that it is the best time to get married for the couples. And it is also prescribed that it is ideal to have 7 years difference, about 7 years difference in the age of the couples. That the male should be about 7 years or a little round about 7 years elder than the female. It has its own biological and psychological and temperamental reasons, which can be explained in a separate lecture. And one of the most obvious reasons they prescribed is that a woman becomes older than a man in many cases, not all cases. So if there is 7 years difference, they have the best type of conjugal enjoyment in life. And when they produce a child, they should begin to treat the child as their own student in their own first institution. This, in short, I conceive as the scheme for the schooling education of the new age. And to start such an institution, couples should get involved for life in the whole scheme. It is not enough if education may be made professional for the teachers or professors, and the it is not enough to have only a school, but it should be a home. And a group of families can gather and make a beginning and see how the progress is. It is more easy in India than in the Occident to make a beginning. So we made a beginning in India about 30 years ago, whereas my father made his beginnings with our own family in a tiny way many years ago. And he educated us in the same lines. And we have an understanding of what he wanted to do. And we could appreciate the progress we had under his education. And we started the same thing with our own families. Now we have our own children and grandchildren brought up under those conditions. And during these 30 years of experimentation with our own children and grandchildren, we are satisfied and more than satisfied with the progress we experience. And we are trying to make a comparatively bigger institutions in the villages of India, making them self-sufficient units, having the following branches: a child school for by parents, children as teachers teaching to their juniors. This is one of the methods we use. That is, children of a higher class, they are trained to teach the children of the lower class, which essentially gives development of certain dimensions in the children. Library run by children, industries run by children. In this aspect, we are a good success. We made the children start some industries, and these children have made a great progress in the line, and they are now able to hand over these things to the next generation and go to the next step of their work. A clinic by the teachers and by the families to cure their own families and children and relatives. And a symbiosis unit, that is a formula of animal, plants and humans. This includes agricultural and other activities. That is, the human being serving the animal, he need not kill it, he can eat from it. And the human being serving the plant and using the plant according to ecology to animals, using the products of the animal for the plants according to ecology. Apply this triangle and train the children to apply this triangle. We are trying to establish such units in the villages. We have made a very tiny beginning very recently. We have to still wait and find for the results. Thank you all. And any relevant questions upon the subject are welcome. It is a worked out solution, and we can take it as it is. Great thinkers like Rudolf Steiner have given us everything worked out. Unless we have community homes or villages and schools like this, we cannot apply Rudolf Steiner's methods in the cities. When once such a community is established, we can make use of Steiner's information and what he taught to the world as it is. They can work from the age of 14, and as teachers they can work from the age of 10.